Thank you so much for the question on amnesty. I remember sometimes in 2015 is when the late minister in charge of internal security, Nkaiseri, made actually a recommendation of having, he declared an amnesty for the youth who are radicalized and who are actually coming back in Kenya in large numbers. As Muslim youth in this country actually appreciated that pronunciation by the then minister. But actually what made it difficult for the implementation of the same is that we didn't have a clear policy guideline that could actually allow the youth to come back and be reintegrated in the country. And I think those are some of the impediments that actually did not yield much as far as that directive is concerned. But as we are speaking now, a civil society organization in this country, we are actually working towards developing a policy framework that will enable this specific pronunciation by the then minister to come to fruition. Because what we have a problem is that the whole issue of taking the youth, receiving the youth and then take it to the government without necessary procedure and processes of monitoring whatever that is they are going to do to do when they are in the hands of the government. So as we are speaking now, we are in the process of developing a framework, a policy, a suggested policy framework that will actually facilitate the implementation of the amnesty. The youth are returning, but they are not coming out as it was expected by the government. What is just happening is that we are just trying to see how can they reintegrate back within the minimum supervision that we can provide as a civil society organization. Because this is a massive task and it requires a lot of resources and a lot of people to be able to realize
different stakeholders.